Tonight's flight will take 12 hours, a long and turbulent flight. These Air Force reservists are trained to fly in these dangerous conditions, bringing along a team of scientists who collect information from the storm using these data collectors, which helps predict where the storm will go and saving millions of dollars in storm preparation and, more importantly, saving lives.
It comes down to evacuate or not evacuate. Emergency management, they have the tough job. Forecasters, they have the tough job. We go in the storm, we get a rough ride, we collect the data. They take that information to help those guys do the tough job of making the hard decisions on who has to evacuate.
Lightning fills the darkness of sky. A few hours into our journey, sunlight reveals clouds and thunderstorms on the horizon. We are heading directly toward Joaquin.
We're just about to punch through the eye wall, meaning we're actually going into the strongest part of the hurricane, feeling winds in excess of 150 miles per hour with a Category 4 just like this. We've experienced severe turbulence and there's more to come.
As we get tossed around inside the cockpit, our seasoned pilot assures us we are in good hands.
Being on this plane, is it structurally sound? Is it safe?
Oh no, you're very safe in the 130.
We are 7,000 feet above the northern Bahamas in the center of Major Hurricane Joaquin. This storm has been notoriously difficult to predict, but the weather data retrieved from the hurricane hunters will help improve the forecast greatly. Multiple drop zones are released into the sky, sending back information like wind speed and storm pressure in real time, right back to computers on board. Joaquin is now pushing north.
Got some bumps coming up.
As we make several passes over the storm, a missing ship is stranded in rough swells. We drop to 600 feet to help search, but thick clouds and bad visibility prevent us from finding the vessel. The hurricane hunters return to their mission, seeking more data from the storm before heading back to Biloxi.